Sky. Sky. Ooh, you like that.
Very upset with myself because I still didn't get help after that. Everybody in my family thought that that was a car
Oh,
accident. And I've always
Scott.
been really good at hiding this side of
Is
myself.
that a cuddle tie?
Anytime at all, people ask me what's going on, I keep myself way too busy. That's always been my style. And back then, as a full-time student at Rutgers University, I had a full-time job and appropriate level of enthusiasm. Many are like, "Oh, Iowa State, you're like, oh, hey, Ty, oh, Rutgers," and you're like, "Wait a minute," and you're like, "I as well." Like, that's really like, I was a full-time student there, I had a full-time job, and I mentioned how much I loved comedy. I found a place willing to let me do it. It's still here, it's in New York, it's called the Upright Citizens Brigade. Great place, great place. I started there when I was 20 years old, and I loved it so much. And one night, I'm driving home from the UCB Theater back to my parents' house in Jersey, where I still live at the time. And it was after a
You
particularly
should
bad show. It was
start
an improvised
doing your
parody of
YouTube name.
Japanese anime cartoons.
What's your birds?
And I was playing a schoolgirl named Yurin.
Oh.
And
Oh.
needless to say, I wasn't feeling great about myself. And I'm driving, I'm like, I'm so exhausted all the time. Why? Like, for that, is any of this being worth it? And I can't breathe in the heat and the pins and needles while I'm driving. And I pull off of Route 46 and I stop in this bank parking lot and I call Teresa. She was my girlfriend in college. And I say, "It's happening again," and I'm driving and it's scary. And she interrupts me. She does what I said. She says, "Look, here's what's gonna happen. You're gonna go home right now. You're gonna wake up your mom and tell her what's going on because I'm
Oh,
calling her,
what's
okay? I'm
that?
going there. First thing tomorrow morning, I'm telling her. So now's your chance to get it done on your terms." She took the choice that night. Thank God, that's what I needed back then. Although, believe me, that night, not into it at all. At all. I'm like, "You can't do that. That's not yours to share. This isn't fair." She's like, "Fair? You want to talk about fair? You still call me about this shit. You dumped me 18 months ago, asshole." Touche, touche. I do what she says. I get home, and it's about 2:30 in the morning, and I walk into my parents' bedroom, and my mom's asleep in bed, and my mom is this 5-foot-nothing, arthritic little Irish
Oh,
cat.
a cute Scott.
And my dad had a job in Puerto Rico for like a year or so. So randomly, he just lived on the island of Puerto Rico at that time. And that means my mom's alone in his bed. It's way too big for just out my mother. And before I touch her, I pause. Because I realize that this little kid. And I almost bail. I almost just walk away, but it's out of my hands. Suicidal, and I'm really scared. And she's blindsided by that. And I never want to see my mom.